assemble a team, but I can't reboot DedSec alone. Let me break into London CTOS and see who's available.
I'm Claire Waters, and we've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin calling in. Colin, what's your take?
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown them in jail. Now, I'll say they should all be lined up and shut.
You don't find it awfully convenient that they've been fingered as the attackers, but we've seen no proof?
Look at town! Look at our city! What more proof do you need?
Well, Colin, I'd say you have to look at their history of non-violent action. Albion's put more civilians in the hospital in the past few months than DedSec ever has. I smell a scapegoat. Now I have Emily calling in. Emily, what's your take?
You're absolutely right, Claire. The government's just framing DedSec because they want to make it seem like they have this under control. They probably have no clue who was behind.
Is worse than I thought. But there's a candidate. Looks like you're DedSec's best hope. Glad to see you're alive. If you're still committed to the cause, DedSec needs you. I'll send you the coordinates to our last safe house. Meet me there.
Sure.
I'm Claire Waters, and we've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin calling in. Colin, what's your take?
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown them in jail. Now, I'll say they should all be lined up and shut.
Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now disabled. Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now disabled. Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now disabled. Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now enabled.
Please! Possible suspect or suspects reported near your location.
I've downloaded a patch to your optics so you can access our security system. It's set up so that I can't just let someone who isn't DedSec in. You'll have to do the manual override.
A manual override to the secret entrance? If I get to hack some nodes later, I'm gonna geek out.
Pursuing the target. Over. Negative. No vision of the suspect. Right, I'm putting a stop to this. Units fall back. Over.
One of Sabine's, are you? I'll see you downstairs later then.
Look at that. Abracadabra! Oi, anyone here? Where are the lights at?
This is the bug. Hello, resistors. It's bug time. Are you all sitting comfortably? No? Good. That's as it should be. This is the bug. I'm Andy, and joining me to analyse the latest blowflies to emerge from the corpse of once free Britain, it's Alice.
Hello, Andy.
And today, we're going to talk to you about Albion, your friends and mine. Alice, the government has extended Albion's contract and have also boasted that violent crime has plummeted to a record low. Now, extending Albion's contract, to me, that's like having a pet dog, let's call it Nigel for the sake of argument, that attacks you every single day and thinking to yourself, wouldn't it be nice if Nigel had puppies?
That contract has been extended so many times, it's like the neck of a...
No DedSec registration detected. Identify yourself, or I'll seal the exits, hack your optic, and read you every drunken email you ever wrote until you starve.
No, not that. Sabine sent me.
Sabine's alive? Well, that's one piece of good news. I'm Bagley, DedSec's definitely not stolen, highly advanced AI assistant, and it seems I've been out of commission for a few months. Anyway, why don't you go connect me to the DedSec network so I can become more powerful than you could possibly imagine? I mean, catch up on what I missed.
Needed.
Welcome back to The Upload. In this episode, we're talking about CTO...
That's it. I'm reconnected to the network, downloading our database, news archives, and... Oh no. Terrorist group DedSec responsible for deadly bombings in London. Dalton Wolf dead?
Hello, and...
I leave you people alone for a second and you immediately cock it all up.
All good question, but if DedSec didn't do the bombings, who did?
There's a gap in my memory after Dalton... Well, let's be honest, after I disarmed the bomb at Parliament. I'm missing information about what happened after I was taken offline. But from what I can infer, an unknown hacker group identified only as Zero Day was involved. I believe this Zero Day staged the attacks and framed DedSec for their dirty work. Come to my terminal. Sabine is requesting a video call.
Patching in Sabine Brandt now. I suggest you listen very closely to anything she has to say.
There you are. I'm glad you made it. Packley, God, it's good to hear your demented little voice. Is your memory intact?
Not even slightly. The last record I have is of our HQ being raided. My only lead is a group known as Zero Day. Ring any bells?
No. But the HQ was attacked by some men in black, the same that were at Parliament. Maybe working together. We didn't stand a chance. They just gunned everyone down.
Holy shit. How did you get out?
I managed to escape through the sewers to Camden. A contact smuggled me out of the city and I've been hiding out in the north since.
Prudent. Your profile is red flagged as a high priority target in the city's surveillance system. Even a partial recognition hit would have you hunted down and shot on sight.
These days, DedSec's about as well loved as a French football team. This shit is so cool, but, well, it's kind of a massive risk.
Listen, if anyone knows anything about risks, it's me. I lost everything and everyone. But it comes down to this. London is in a death spiral. And if DedSec can't pull it out, trust me, no one can. The city needs a resistance. And it starts with you. What do you say?
Who am I kidding? Yeah. Let's do it.
Excellent. New user registered. Welcome to DedSec.
Now, it would be irresponsible of us to release you naked and mewling into the wild. You'll find equipment around the safe house that are essential items in your DedSec kit. We have a sophisticated system for hiding your identity from facial recognition tech. It's called a mask. And while we're here, perhaps we can talk about updating your wardrobe. I mean, look at you. Come on.
You've got all these fancy new toys, but it's also important to know the basics. You need to learn how to throw a punch and how to take one. Albion will escalate if you come at them with a gun and shoot you down. We want to avoid collateral damage. In DedSec, we try to use guns only as a last resort.
Have you already met Connie Robinson? She owns the pub and is an old DedSec contact, not to mention a champion.
Start with some basic strikes. Hit me. Don't be shy. You'll want to get in under my block. Find the weak point. Nice one. Quick on your feet now. You want to create distance. That's it! Nice one!
Gear in order? Know enough not to punch yourself in the face or get shot for pulling out a gun too early? Brilliant. I'm working out how we find Zero Day and ruin their day, but I need someone with actual legs to do the legwork. Hope you're ready.
We have some damage control to do if we...
dumbass.
Hey, what's up?
Heard you need some help. What's up?
This is about my friend, isn't it? Oh, God. He's okay, right? He's in way over his head.
Go on.
He's destroying his life with this stupid gambling. I tried to help him get out of debt, but no. Now he's off to meet those Clan Kelly thugs. They're going to kill him.
Yeah, that's not good. I'll see what we can do.
I've tracked our naughty little gambler to a location that's crawling with Clan Kelly goons.
We've got to check it out.
Searching for the source.
Your safety and security are of utmost importance.
One year ago, three undocumented youths were beaten to death on a high street in Chelsea when an optic video surfaced showing the men dying at the hands of Albion guards. Riots erupted, demanding justice for the Chelsea Three.
Our gambler is nearby. I suppose they might make it out on their own, but going off the number of goons here, I don't like the odds. Get to him fast.
Back up!
hostage is in here. Let's get him out.
Oh, let go! You're hurting me! Help me.
Thank you.
Well done. Let's make sure they're all right.
Are you okay?
I didn't need your help, you know. I had it all under control. All right, fine. I didn't. Damn. I really thought this con was rock solid.
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, that debt. Fake debt. Or real debt that I got fakely. I wanted to get abducted, innit? Once I was in, I was going to get him with a crypto-stealing Trojan. Only they got me first.
No shit, Sherlock.
Wait, I know. You guys can upload the virus for me. You're big, strong people. I'll cut you in and everything.
Piss easy. I got this.
So he was actually gambling with his own life. Talk about raising the stakes.
We can help with that. He'll be so grateful, I bet he joins up.
I found the Kelly lieutenant who should make a great target for the crypto-draining virus. I'll send you their details now. That's pretty much the opposite of what our prospect would have wanted. Oh, well.
Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now disabled. Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now enabled. Auto drive now enabled.
Albion have established an operational base in the Royal Court of Justice.
So, Albion takes over the courts and suddenly everyone they don't like just ends up in jail? Yeah, I'm sure that's just a coincidence.
Exactly. But it likely means there's information here about how Albion are targeting dissenters, the who and the why. We need that data if we're going to disrupt their operation.
Blessed life.
Wait, what? Stop!
You can run!
Well, go on.
something over.
Bagley, what you got for me?
A list of what Albion consider high-value targets that are threats to the peaceful running of London. See here, a journalist, and this one runs a community shelter. Good God, bar your doors.
WT fuck?
All suspected of sowing rebellion or exhibiting tendencies towards... Albion is systematically arresting people even before they rise up. Joke's on them. This list can actually help us find like-minded allies willing to help us. Well done. Now, let's disrupt some of Albion's propaganda and give some hope to the people.
Autodrive now enabled.
As the hunger strike of 6 migrants currently being held at the Kennington Oval enters its 10th day, officials released a statement indicating that force-feeding procedures would commence in order to safeguard the lives of the protesters. International agencies have called the situation a humanitarian crisis. Join us on GBB tonight as we look at migrants, detention, and the prospects for a solution to this complicated and contentious issue.
Autodrive now enabled. Autodrive now enabled.
Hey, good news. I just scratched off my Albion propaganda bingo card. Guess they don't want us forgetting who's in charge, right?
There's going to be that much less once you're done here. Let's give Camden a break from these eyesores.
Piss easy. I got this.
Autodrive now enabled.
If you hijacked that scissor lift, you could use it to access the rooftop.
Yes, nicely done. That'll get people's attention. Let them know someone is standing up to Albion. Light the spark that they can stand up to.
If nothing else, it'll relieve their eye strain.
What now?
We're already seeing results from what you've done. That list we found named a journalist in Camden who's been investigating Albion. We reached out and he's got information that can help us. I think you should meet with him.
Send me the coordinates.
Message received. Moving in. Over.
Here's our suspect. Over.
Auto drive.
Target has cleared the checkpoint. Over.